To you a little bit about the Miracle on Hudson pilot, Captain Sully Sullenberger, who published an op-ed in Market Watch on Boeing and the FAA, and he writes this: "Our credibility as leaders in aviation is being damaged. Boeing and the FAA have found wanting in this ugly saga that began years ago, but has come home to roost with two terrible fatal crashes and no survivors. In less than 5 months, on a new airplane type, the Boeing 737 MAX 8, something that is unprecedented in modern aviation history." So can you just sort of explain a little bit about the criticism that the FAA is facing over these crashes? And I'm curious what they're doing to sort of fix their reputation on this.
Well, I can tell you from having talked with Sully about the Lion Air crash, he was very frustrated about the lack of communication out of Boeing and the FAA about this anti-stall system. To expect pilots to, in the middle of an emergency, while you're focused on trying to stay in the air, you know, there is a certain amount of tunnel vision that happens, and knowing about MCAS or perhaps properly designing the system in the first place, really can't be lost in this conversation. So you have a the way that an airplane is certified in the U.S., the way it's approved for flight, is a very cozy arrangement between the FAA and an airplane manufacturer like Boeing, and it's cozy by design. The FAA does not have the staff, it says, to fully do that certification work itself, and in many cases, the belief is the manufacturer is in some ways better positioned to do that work as they're going about building the aircraft. And in this case, the 737, as it's an existing airframe, it's a process where some of the things have already been certified on the plane. That, by the way, is codified by Congress. Congress, after 9/11, passed legislation allowing the FAA to hand over more of the certification to the manufacturer, including safety systems. So Boeing does essentially self-certify the aircraft. They provide data to the FAA to support that they have gone through the, basically the checklist, if you will, to oversimplify it a bit. And then here's our data that shows that what we're telling you is true, and that gets verified. But in the MAX case, there are some really legitimate questions about things that were missed or perhaps were not questioned sufficiently on the part of the FAA. MCAS, this anti-stall system, appears to have what they would call a single point of failure, meaning one of the two angle of attack sensors failed, and that's what created the Lion Air incident, investigators believe.
It's just fascinating to sort of see how they're piecing together the puzzle here. Kris Van Cleve, I want to thank you so much for joining us.
Sure thing.